How is it going, guys? Drew Peacock here, back with another video. And I know I told you guys we were going to be doing a subscriber roast today, but you guys beat me at my own game. You guys sent me really good builds, and it was just too hard to actually roast them. So I want to give you guys a round of applause right here. Yeah, give it to my flock members, man. You guys sent me some real good builds, and honestly, I was like, damn, how am I going to roast this? How am I going to roast that? What can I say about this? I know I could say something about every car, but I didn't want it to sound repetitive because these builds were just good. So I'm sorry, we can't do a subscriber roast today. I'll do the next best thing. We will do a subscriber rice or nice. Tomorrow, I will try to pull shittier cars, I guess, so I can actually roast them. But again, I was really surprised by the cars I pulled today. You guys have some really good builds in this episode. So I just want to thank you guys for that. You guys are awesome. Anyway, if this video gets 7,000 likes, I will try to do a subscriber roast tomorrow, and I will just pick much, much shittier cars, or at least cars that are more open to roast. Stop wasting time. I know you guys want to see if your car made it into this episode. If you want to send me your car, go ahead and hit that like button, get this video to 7,000 likes, and then send me your car at drewpeacock.clips@gmail.com for a chance to be in tomorrow's subscriber roast. That is, if we make it to the like goal. Anyway, let's go ahead and dive right in. First car, we have a pretty clean New Edge Mustang GT. This is one of the contenders for the cars that my girl is looking at. Not this exact one, but I'm telling her to get a New Edge Mustang GT. I think she'd have a lot of fun with it. And it is a solid platform to build this one. Nice aftermarket wheels, aftermarket headlights, carbon fiber hood, if it's legit, bride seats. I mean, it's a nice looking New Edge. And these cars will surprise you. They're solid platforms, and they're one of my favorite looking Mustangs. So starting this episode off right with a nice clean little Mustang. Next car though, we got a nice R32 Skyline right here. Exterior, we got some aftermarket wheels, but the whole car is pretty subtle. Rear end, I mean, look at that. That's a good looking rear end right there. Iconic. You don't have to do much to these cars to make them look nice. They already look nice from factory. Underneath the hood, we can see the RB26. He didn't go and swap it. Good. That's great to see. But overall, see, this is the kind of stuff I was talking about. Like, what can I say about this car? What can I say? It's not an R34. See, I mean, but who cares? It's an R32. Next car, we got an SRT boat. He got his car to match his pressure washer. Looks stock here, but it looks like he also has a drag pack setup, which is nice. I mean, if you own one of these, I'm pretty sure you got some forged stars or some welds in your garage anyway. Because it's not like you're going to be hitting up a canyon in this shit. You buy this car to go straight. And so you better have some drag pack wheels somewhere. Anyway, a nice looking Challenger. Love the paint. Next car, WRX. Slammed. Looks like it must be on bags because there's no way that front bumper would be that clean. See, I'm not against camber. This is a little bit of camber, but it adds to the car. It follows the body lines. He's not doing it to be some Instagram clout chaser or something like that. It's a really clean Subaru. And it's one that I personally wouldn't even mind driving around. I would just need a vape to go with it, and I'd fit right in. Don't forget about the snapback, too. Little Miata NA. I believe the email said this one was supercharged, so it's probably a whole lot of fun. Probably surprised the shit out of a bunch of BRZ owners trying to race it. Aftermarket wheels and fitment looks great. Pop-up headlights. Looks like it got some halos in there. I mean, Miatas are just adorable. They look like they belong in the Cars movie. I still need to review one of these. I've been in the NCs and the NDs, but I've never been in an NA. This one, though, looks like a lot of fun. Next car, we have a nice S14. This is a car that a lot of you guys think I'm getting. You might be right, you might be wrong. Who knows? We'll have to see when my car arrives. But this one is real nice. Again, didn't go and slam it out. Didn't go and put crazy camber on it. This one looks like it's ready to go down a canyon or it's ready to hit a highway. I don't know what it's built for, but it looks like it's packing some power. S14s are great looking cars. I don't know which one I like more, the S13 or the S14. I feel like the S14s look a little bit more modern, of course, but I mean, the S13, I mean, it almost looks timeless. Either way, a great looking car. Next car, we have a 3 Series BMW. We got hood pins, we got blue BBS wheels. It looks like a drift car. I don't know if he actually swings it. And then we have, of course, the smokestack exhaust. 328i drop top. I mean, is it a drift car? I don't know. I don't know if I would drift a drop top, but that's just me. Might as well. I guess no one really likes them anyway, but this one looks like it's been through the ringer a few times. It's missing some things. It's not the worst thing ever, but the wheels just, it just doesn't work for me. I'm not feeling it. This, on the other hand, well, this looks completely different. I don't think I've ever seen this body kit on one of these before. Usually we see the Rocket Bunny and those other kits that we see, but this one, I mean, this is a really nice kit. I don't know if it's just a newer version of a kit that we've seen or what, but I've never seen this one personally before. And the fitment and the camber, I mean, it just complements it so well. Again, you don't have to crazy camber the shit out of your car. You don't have to slam your car. He's got it on bags, obviously. In this picture, it's low. This picture, it's high. He did it right. It might be missing some shit right here, but who cares? It looks clean. Someone sent me a picture of a fence. Don't know what I'm going to talk about on this one. Oh, and a stop sign, I guess. But why? I mean, there's no... Oh, okay. Oh, no, they sent me a picture of wheels. Okay, I see the wheels. What am... Oh, it's a Corvette. Okay, it's a C5 Corvette. I couldn't see it. The camouflage was just blending it in. Wow. Okay, a little wide body C5. Whoa, whoo, That's pretty clean. See, my original plan was to buy a Corvette after the Mustang, but I felt like I should get a JDM car, you know, kind of diversify the channel. And a C5 Corvette was a contender. Same with a C6. This one right here with this wide body. Ooh, I might have just found my next car because this is a really, really clean looking car. I don't think there's one thing on this car I don't like. I think everything about it just complements it. So far, probably my favorite car of the episode. This, on the other hand, well, everything I think he's done to this car probably takes away from it. So we have a neon green Camaro, not an SS, not a Z01, nothing cool. It looks like he debadged it or it's just a base model. And he went and threw a crazy wrap on it and put Lambo doors on it. What do you guys think about this? Personally, I think it's a little too much RICE just for me. But, I mean, if it's your style, it's your style. You gotta do what you gotta do, okay? It's your car. You can do whatever you want. But, you're still on stock wheels and you put Lambo doors on it. I don't know. I would have got new wheels first. That's just me. Honda hatch right here. Another car people are thinking I'm getting. Let's see. I want you guys to guess. Keep guessing down in the comments. What car do you think I'm getting? It is a JDM car. It is coming from Australia or some shit. So, it is right-hand drive. But let me know what you guys think. Again, I can't wait. It's arriving in Florida in a few days. I can't wait. Oh, my God. I'm getting a little stiff just thinking about it. Anyways, this nice Honda hatch right here. I like these. This was almost my first car right here. Not a Type R or anything like that. But when I was looking to buy a car, a lot of Honda hatches were popping up. And I back then thought they were really douchey. And I still kind of do now. You know, when I see these cars, I just connect the dot with a Ricer, snapback, vaping. I'm a little bit happy I didn't get one back then. But now, I think I'd be able to make a nice build out of one if I did get one. And this one just looks nice and simple. Didn't do anything too crazy to it because it's a good looking car. You don't got to ruin it. See, because then when you do something a little bit too crazy like this, then stuff starts to look a little bit funky. So at first I saw this picture and I was like, what the hell am I looking at? It looks like a Genesis, but what the hell am I looking at? It looks like Darth Vader had sex with a Genesis. Well, it kind of looks a lot like that when you look at it a little bit more. It looks weird. I'm not feeling it. It looks like an Aston Martin front bumper. I don't know. I'm not really feeling it. It's not my style. It doesn't even look like it fits properly. Like, there's a lot of panel gap. I don't know. It looks a little bit weird. The rear end does look nice. So you just put a bag over the face, and then you'll have some fun with it. Little Teggy right here. Another car that people are saying I'm getting. I just sold one. Why would I want another Integra? So you could just scratch that off the list right now. I'm not getting an Integra. I just got rid of mine. This one is nice. We got a nice Type R Integra right here. It would be a fun car. Again, I would love to review one of these, and I love that yellow paint job on it. I miss cars that have nice paint jobs, nice colors. I miss that. You know, back then, I feel like they were going for that wow factor with the car. And still today, there are cars that do come like this. But you could drive on a freeway and you see a lot of black, gray, silver, white. It's basic, man. I miss the good old days. And this Type R right here is rocking that yellow paint job. Great. Little Camaro RS right here. I mean, it's not the worst thing ever, but it's not the best thing ever. Wheel setup, I actually like. Red halo headlights, whatever. I mean, I guess you're not doing too much crazy shit with it. Just everything else with it, with the whole, I mean, I would have just bought an SS, but I get it. You know, some people don't care about that stuff, and that's fine. You don't have to go for straight up power. The rear end I do like. The louvers look legit. The little ducktail looks legit. I just, again, it's on an RS, and personally, I would have just gone for the SS. But as long as you just leave it like this, I think it's fine. I think if you go a little bit too much and you go past this, I think then you start to just look a little bit weird. But this, you're not really harming anything. Another V6 muscle car. This one is an older Charger. We got some, I think, what look like aftermarket headlights, some nice aftermarket wheels. They don't look too bad either. Ride height is a little bit bad, but it might just be this photo. This car doesn't look too bad, but then we see the crowning jewel of this car. Clearly, Wolverine got to this one too. Wolverine is just on a spree. He's just getting everyone's car right now. Look, if you have these in your shopping cart somewhere, I know you guys got your stimulus check. Don't waste it on these. Don't waste it on these little claw marks, okay? It doesn't look cool. I don't think anyone thinks these look cool. But you can do what you want. Here we go. We got another 3 Series BMW. And this one looks like it's ready to drift. This one looks like he's ready to swing it, and I'll show you why in a second. But exterior-wise, looks nice. We got some white wheels. We got a nice dark brown or dark purple paint job. I can't really tell. It looks like it changes colors in different lighting. But it looks nice. It looks part of the era. A nice rolling shot of it. Looks nice. Looks like it's ready to hit up a track. And then we go into the interior. We got a hydraulic handbrake. I mean, this just looks like a whole lot of fun right here. I would at some point in the future like to build a drift car. I think it'd be a whole lot of fun to learn how to drift good. But I just don't know if I'd be down to like crash my car at the same time. So I don't know. We'll see. I'll have to get a beater for it. But this one looks like a lot of fun. And now we have come to the real AE86, or at least I hope it is. See, I love this style of wheels, that classic Japanese look on the wheels. These are the ones that I would like to get for the 200SX. Technically, I don't own that car anymore, so we'll have to see what my girlfriend wants to do with it. But these wheels with the nice little flares on it, I mean, it just fits it real well. And this guy also is swinging it, so we got two back-to-back drifters. Again, how would I roast this car? How? I can't. It looks nice. Yeah, I mean, it's popular because of an anime, and that's kind of like the only reason. But still, how would I roast this? You see what I had to work with? You guys just sent me some great ass shit. I can't really do much. This, on the other hand, looking like a tattoo that The Rock would have. Well, this one is roastable. This one is very roastable. Looks a little bit too crazy for me. Someone said, how big would you like your tribal decal to look? And he just said yes. Here we go. Probably the cleanest Mustang of the episode. It looks like a GT and a Cobra, but it has the V6 badge on the side, so I'm not really sure what's going on here. I know the earlier GTs did come with that badge, so it could just be a real early New Edge, but either way, he's killing it. We got the shaker hood, nice aftermarket wheels, great fitment. Love the Cobra front end. It's a great looking Mustang. I just wish I knew what it was. I mean, honestly, even if this was a V6 as a daily driver, this is a great looking V6. And lastly, we've made it to the Kia Stinger with a beautiful wrap or paint job, whatever it is. It is just beautiful. This is a great color right here. I don't think it would work on my Mustang, but on a Kia like this or an import, it would look beautiful. I mean, look at this. Wheel setup too. I mean, they work with the car. They're not my favorite, but they work with the car. Kia Stingers, man. Real nice cars. And this one just... everything that he's done to it kind of complements it too, and he got rid of that stupid stripe right here. Thank you. He got rid of the stupid side marker, and it looks way better. God, Kia, what were you thinking? What were you thinking with that stupid side marker? Looks way better like this. Anyways, that's going to do it for this video. If you did enjoy this video, please leave a thumbs up. Like I said, you guys sent me some real good builds this episode. I am honestly happy. It would have been fun to roast a lot of you guys, but I mean, looking at your guys' sick-ass builds is great too. If you want to see me roast your guys' builds, get this video to 7,000 likes, and I will force myself to do it tomorrow. Anyways, subscribe to see more videos like this one, and until next video, peace.